Okay, this is the Prepared Texan, and this is my full comprehensive review of the Taurus 24/7 Pro DS. This particular model is the titanium slide, and it is the compact version. The standard version is a little longer. I'm not exactly sure how much longer, but it's longer than this. And the butt's longer as well. So this is the compact model. I've already done an overview of this, showing the controls, the takedown pin, slide stop, safety and decocker, etc. One thing I didn't though show on the other video was takedown, so I'm going to show that real quick before I get started here. Make sure it's empty. Chamber's completely empty. Do a tactile check as well. Nothing in there. So, to take it down, once you have it empty and the magazine out, you want to turn this pin 90 degrees down. So it looks like that. You just pull it out, release the slide, pull the trigger, and pull the slide off. And it's easy as that. And then your spring comes out and your barrel. Like a lot of other semi-auto pistols. Put it back in. It would help if I was looking at the firearm instead of screen. You just put your barrel back in. Put your spring back in. Slide it back on. Lock it back. Put the pin in. And when you reinsert the pin, you want to make sure that it's going in the normal sideways locked position. You might need to jiggle it a little at first to get it going. Then once you push it in, you want it to already be in that position. And there you have it. And put the empty magazine back in. So, that's the basic overview. You got your Picatinny rail, your trigger, and all that stuff. So today I'm going to go over a little bit more about this particular firearm. Okay, let me put a snap cap in so I can show you the trigger function. Now, like I've shown before, it has the double and single action trigger. Single action, of course, when you first load it, and with the option to decock it and put it into double action. So in single action, the trigger goes all the way back to there pretty freely, extremely light, and then you got a little bit of pull, and then it fires. It goes into double action, it's decocked, there's no red dot there, and it's a little stiffer. Now one thing I have noticed about this trigger is it has a long reset. Starts there, pull it back. Right there it clicks. It fires. You hear click? Nothing. Up to there, still nothing. Hear that little click right there? That's the reset. You have to bring the trigger all the way back up to there before you pull it back again. There's nothing going on there. So if your style of rapid fire involves going like that, you might not like this trigger. Although for me, I found that I can rapid fire it just fine. I just have to make sure I bring the trigger all the way forward. But that might be an issue for you and something you may consider. So before you purchase this or any firearm, I recommend that you always feel the trigger and see how you like it. Not only with this, but any firearm, like I've said. Okay, so that's the controls and the takedown. Let me talk a little bit about firepower. This is the compact version, and it holds 13 in the magazine and one in the chamber, so a total of 14 in 9mm. In 40 Smith & Wesson, I believe it's 12, and 10 in 45 ACP, I believe. I'll annotate that as well down here. But I've covered all that in my other video, so that's not really a big issue. So, it's a good amount of firepower. And for the size, I think it does really well. It has an available extended magazine, which is the same size magazine that comes in the full size 24/7. 17 rounds of 9mm plus one in the chamber, a total of 18 rounds. Not bad. So, as far as firepower versus size, I think this definitely is worth the size of this firearm for the amount of firepower you get, and vice versa. Oh, let me show you real quick with my tape measure. It's about 6 1/4 inches from the top of from the front of the slide to the end of the slide, and from the top of the rear sight to the bottom of the grip, the very longest part is about 5 1/2 inches in the compact model. So it's relatively small, and the width, the back of the slide, just over 1 inch, middle of the grip, under 1 1/4 inches, maybe right at 1 1/4 inches at its fattest part. So the size, it's fairly compact. I don't have an extremely accurate scale, I just have a bathroom scale, so I haven't weighed it. But according to their website, it weighs about 20.3 ounces. So that's not too bad. I'm assuming that's empty. So once you load it up, it'll be a little heavier than that. Although with my holster I have, which is a Crossbreed Super Tuck, I noticed that I can wear it all day, like from when I wake up to when I go to bed, put it on, take it off. I can wear it all day long and it not bother me. I barely even know it's there. I mean, I know it's there. I mean, I know I'm wearing a gun, but I'm not constantly thinking about it or noticing it on me, if that makes sense. So I think the size and weight and the firepower, the contrast of the two, this for me is the perfect size semi-automatic defensive pistol. You'll notice I have tape in 3 different places on it. It's just a little bit of masking tape. It'll won't leave any marks on it. But that's just for the purposes of this video. They put the serial number on it 3 times. Once on the barrel, once on the slide, and once on the frame. I don't know if that's a compliance thing for various places that they ship these. But they definitely wanted to make sure that the serial number was stamped on it. So, if you live in a place where you have to have it all 3 of those places, you're compliant. I don't know if that's a requirement anywhere or if they just did it. But, there you have it. I'll give you a look at this side here. I'm showing you the other side, but I haven't really shown you this side. You'll notice there's a little bit of wear on it. Although, I'm sure some of that will clean off. That's probably just from the holster. Let me rephrase that. I'm sure that's from the holster. And then that there's your key lock. I never use that. I don't see any reason to have that on a defensive pistol. And your loaded chamber indicator, right now it's unloaded. It's flush. Okay, next talking point, dependability. I've had this over 7 months now, and I've used it many a time. I try to practice with it every month at least, since this is my carry firearm. I have my concealed handgun license here in Texas, and I am legal to carry this. So I do so whenever it is legal. Whenever it is legal to carry my firearm, I carry my firearm. 'Cause you never know when and where something might happen. That's just a little bit of philosophy, and that has nothing to do with this particular firearm except for the fact that this is specifically, since this is the compact model, designed for concealed carry. That's a little bit of a tangent, but the point is, I carry this every single day, and I practice with it at least once every single month. And I've had nothing break, nothing give out, nothing show really anywhere, other than maybe some slight scratches, or not even scratches, but slight markings on the slide from the holster. But like I said, most of that cleans off. So it's made pretty well. That's a very solid polymer. Titanium slide, what more needs to be said about titanium? It's available in stainless and blued steel as well. I don't have either one, so I couldn't tell you much about that other than I'm sure they're just fine. As far as cycling rounds, I haven't had too much problems with it, although I have had some problems with it. Let me get some empty brass here so I can show you the kinds of malfunctions that I've had. And I don't know if these particular malfunctions are based on user error, which they most likely are since I'm a relatively novice shooter. This is my first handgun. Or if they're based on actual problems with the firearm, which I kind of doubt. But one day I was out shooting. Actually, let me take that out. Rack it back first before I put that in. One day I was out shooting and I was having issues where it wouldn't fully eject the case. And it would look about like that. So if you have more knowledge and experience than me, and you know exactly why that would happen, let me know. I don't know if it was a problem with Wimpresting or with the extractor or with the magazine or what. But just one day that I used it, I had some issues like that. One day I had that issue. Luckily, that's an easy enough issue to fix. And you're back in business. And then the other day, my wife were out shooting. My wife and I were out shooting. And we had another interesting issue. The brass turned backwards in the chamber. I'll show a little clip of the video from that day. And you can see that the brass is actually turned backwards, and I'm not sure why that happened or how that happened. So if you have any thoughts on that either, please let me know in your comments and take it for what it's worth. So I have put, many, many rounds through this, and those are pretty much the only malfunctions that I've had. And that could be ammo, it could be me, it could be the gun, it could be the magazine, I am not sure. So take that with a grain of salt, and it's a data point. But it doesn't necessarily mean the gun is crap, and it doesn't necessarily mean the gun is great either. And last of all, let's talk about value. This particular firearm, admittedly, I got on sale. I got it on clearance at the end of the run. This is the G1, the first gen DS model. They now have the Gen 2 Taurus 24/7s out on the market. So I got this at a real good price for, I believe, under $500 with the titanium slide. I've seen the blued steel go for $330 or so. So they're very affordable for what you're getting. And I think it's money well spent. For me, this is my perfect carry gun. I carry it every single day. everywhere it's legal. And that's pretty much all I have to say about it. If you have any questions about it, or would you like to see more particulars about it, or anything like that, please let me know in the comments. Don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the page, so you can see more videos like this. This is the Prepared Texan, and y'all have a great day.